So a bunch of math YouTubers are doing this big crossover event where they talk about their hashtag MegaFavNumbers. That is, their favorite numbers over 1 million. And no, I wasn't exactly invited to participate, but I'm also not really a math YouTuber, so it makes sense. I mean, yeah, this is my third consecutive video about math, but hey, this isn't about me, this is about numbers. So what's my favorite number over a million? Weird question, but why exactly is 1 million the cutoff point? Isn't that a bit, I don't know, decimal-centric? Is there anything special about the number 1 million that doesn't rely on the way it's represented in base 10? Well, we can actually use the online encyclopedia of integer sequences to search for sequences that contain any individual number, which is a good way of seeing what properties a number has. Now, there are 1,703 sequences in the OEIS that contain the number 1 million. So the first result that shows up is that 1 million is a power of 10. Fair enough, but is there anything 1 million has going for it that 100,000 and 10 million don't? Why this power of 10? Well, we can just exclude those from our search and find out. Well, now we've found that 1 million is a number to the power 6, which means that it's both a perfect square and a perfect cube. So, okay, that's also pretty interesting, but again, why 10 to the 6th and not 9 to the 6th or 11 to the 6th? Well, excluding those two, we can now see that 1 million is the total number of subsets of the nth roots of 1 that add to 0. What? Okay, so like a root of 1 is a number where if you raise it to some integer exponent, you get 1. And for real numbers, there's only 1 and negative 1 where you can do that, but when you look at complex numbers, there's a lot more. So if you look at this sequence, right, you can see that when n equals 2, there's 2 subsets of the nth roots of 1 that add to 0. So what that means is that there's 2 ways to write 0 as the sum of some distinct square roots of 1. So then what the fact that 1 million is integer number 36 in the sequence actually means is that there are 1 million ways to write 0 as the sum of distinct 36th roots of 1. What was I talking about? Oh, right, the number 1 million. So my favorite mega number is 720,720. The thing I like about it is that it's a superior, highly composite number. I've spoken about SHCNs in the past, but I haven't really talked about what they actually are. So let's do that. First, let's talk about normal highly composite numbers, just because they're easy to explain. So, every positive integer has some amount of divisors, and some have more than others, but which ones have the most divisors? Of course, there's no upper bound on how many divisors a given integer can have, but one easy way to formalize the idea that an integer has just a whole lot of divisors is for it to have more divisors than any smaller positive integer. If a positive integer has more divisors than any smaller positive integer, then it's a highly composite number. And the highly composite numbers, you know, they're pretty good. They've got a whole bunch of divisors, but the superior highly composite numbers are way better. So for superior highly composite numbers, you're not just counting divisors, you're doing something a bit more complicated. So you take your positive integer n, right, and you count how many divisors it has. Now pick some small positive real number epsilon and raise n to the power epsilon. Now take the number of divisors of n and divide it by n to the epsilon. If a number is a superior highly composite number, that means that there is some number epsilon you can pick where doing that function to this number has an output that's greater than or equal to the output of that function for any other positive integer. What that means is that there's a way of counting divisors that takes into account how small numbers tend to have fewer divisors than large numbers, and using this adjusted way of counting factors, some numbers can be said to be more composite than all other integers. And in fact, there's infinitely many of these superior highly composite numbers. SHCNs have a lot of fun properties, but really, it's just great that they can be divided in so many different ways, which brings us back to 720,720. 720,720 has 240 divisors. It's divisible by every integer from 1 through 16, every even integer from 1 through 30, and every threeven integer from 1 through 24. Oh, and hey, if you want a numbering system, base 720,720, which I call icosifetabakerheptelevenary for reasons, it would be absurdly difficult to learn, but it would also be extremely elegant. There's so many nice properties that would come with using it. Right, so here's the thing. 720,720 is a great number, but it's also not bigger than a million. While it is roughly the same size as a million, it is also very obviously less than a million, so I cannot call it my hashtag mega fave number. I mean, sure, I could just go up to the next superior highly composite number and talk about 1,441,440, but like, it doesn't even have that many more factors is the thing. Like, okay, the SHCN before 720-720 is 55,440, which has 120 divisors, and like, 720-720 has 240 divisors, right? So it's literally twice as many. But then 1,441,440 only has 288? Like, ooh, big deal, it's 48 more divisors from a number that's twice the size. Like, come on. But sure, 720-720 is less than a million, but that's not the number in the thumbnail, is it? At what point will I bring up the number 23,240,400? Oh, I guess right now. Okay, so right, my hashtag MegaFavNumber is, in fact, 23240400. It is not, however, 23,240,400. Surprise, it's base 6. 720,720 in decimal is equal to dozen 3 nif dozen 4 unexian 4 nif in sexsimal. Is this cheating? Yes. Do I care? Immensely. But this just gets me back to that initial question. Why 1 million? I suppose there just had to be some cutoff somewhere and 1 million is a nice round number, but is it? I'd say that dozen 3 dozen 4 oh 4 nif is a much rounder number than 33 dozen 3 33 44. And sure, 33 dozen 3 33 44 is quote unquote bigger than dozen 3 dozen 4 oh 4 nif, but like, they're the same order of magnitude. I think it's fine. Anyway, thanks for watching. I guess if you're into math stuff, you should check out the MegaFavNumbers playlist, and if you're coming here from the MegaFavNumbers playlist and this is the first of my videos you're seeing, then thanks, I guess. I make a lot of stuff on this channel, including a handful of videos about math. I made a video about regular polyhedra pretty recently that did pretty well. You'd probably like that if you like math. Anyway, that's it. I don't have a sign-off.